Tom, the argument goes something like this. They have to live somewhere, but people with children say, okay, but not near me or where my kids go to school. But now a judge has ruled that registered sex offenders can live wherever they want. And unless the city of Dover challenges that ruling, other New Hampshire towns may be facing similar court challenges in the future.
You may remember Richard Jennings. He was in the news for failing to register in the city of Dover as a sex offender and was accused of living with his fiance here on Locust Street, not far from a kindergarten, in violation of Dover's ordinance barring sex offenders from living within 2,500 feet of a school or daycare. Now, Mr. Jennings finds himself on the winning side of a court proceeding with the help of a staff attorney from the New Hampshire Civil Liberties Union.
I'm thrilled. I think what the judge clearly saw is that these laws trying to restrict where a registered sex offender lives do not have the intended consequence.
Less thrilled, Dover parents, who even if they didn't know about the ordinance, are upset to learn they're losing a layer of protection.
I'm a little shocked that they would overturn something like that, but I mean, I agree they do have to live somewhere. I just don't want them around my children.
2,500 feet is just under half a mile. That put a large percentage of the city off limits to the 26 or so registered sex offenders who are living in Dover. But now they can live wherever they want. It's their right, according to Judge Weaver, who states in this 19-page ruling that the ordinance not only steps on the state of New Hampshire's laws already in place to govern sex offenders, but also violates their right to equal protection under the law. Local officials are surprised and disappointed by the decision.
I feel that the ordinance was a tool to help protect children, and that's just one less tool I feel that we have.
Now, the city of Dover could appeal this decision to the state Supreme Court. Right now, they're trying to weigh their options and see if they could win on appeal and if it's worth the time and money. If they appeal, what the state Supreme Court decides becomes mandate for every other New Hampshire town with similar ordinances. Live in the newsroom tonight, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.